So if I was thinking of paradise, I would say that paradise is ICTS, with the flowers, with the trees, with the birds, the song of the birds every morning, and with mathematics at the same time. So I am kind of tired after these two talks, especially the last one. So I will go slowly. And in fact, what I am going to speak of is just as its infancy. There have been, since 50 years, let us say, mathematicians developed a series of complex representations of reductive p-adic groups and automorphic representation. But because of relation with arithmetic, given by this wonderful result between automorphic representation and the Galois representation of Galois group, one needs to develop a series of representation of p-adic reductive group over fields that are not complex fields. And this talk about is about that. So, representations. Of reductive p-adic group. Arbitrary. And I will consider only smooth one, which means there is no topology on the field, coefficient field, but there is a p-adic topology on the group. So this is what means smooth. No topology on the coefficient ring. In fact, one should also develop representation over arbitrary rings, or at least Noetherian rings. And this had been done a little bit, but not very much. So today it's only field. So I take F, a field that is, but also F over Fp of t. And the group, the reductive p-adic group, will be the rational point of this is a connected, this one, connected reductive group over F. So there's a big difference between characteristic zero, extension of QP, and over FP of T. In the first case, it's a p-adic analytic group, and not in the second case. And it makes a difference when you are interested to work with representation over a field of characteristic P. So, and so I take representation, I take pi, which is an R representation. G, continuous, meaning that it's smooth, that pi is equal to the union. So every vector is fixed by an open compact subgroup. So they are the fixed vector. And it's very important that the representation be admissible, which means that the dimension of the pi k be finite. Because this smooth representation is usually infinite dimensional, so one needs some finiteness condition, otherwise doesn't work. But still, we want to work with all the categories of representation over R of G. I put infinity to explain that I really want smooth. This condition that you have this. In fact, it's important to have smooth, and when R is a characteristic of car, so characterization of R, I will call it C. When C is equal to P, Smooth is quite important, because if you want, for instance, to take the contragradient representation, meaning the smooth linear forms, there are none if the representation is infinite dimensional, which is very different from the case C is equal to P, or C different from P. And this comes from the fact that when C is equal to P, there is no R measure. So this case is very different from the case C different from P. So I'll start with something, is that first theorem, irreducible implies admissible. If C different from P, this is false when C is equal to P. And you have a counterexample by Daniel Lee for GL2 Q P square equal to G, unramified extension of degree 3 over QP, and F is equal to F R. So how do you construct irreducible admissible representation? Is by induction. So you have P is equal to Nn, parabolic subgroup, with Levy and unipotent radical. Then you have this parabolic induction, which can be defined over any ring. I mean, R can be a ring, doesn't matter. From representation of M to representation over R of G. That is, so you if you start here, you go here, which is a function of G over in row, that F P G is equal to M F of G, and you want this is a parabolic induction, but we want it smooth, so you with the action of G by right translation, but you want fixed by some K, and you take the union over K. And we have P is equal to M. And you go to here. So this is theorem. This has two adjuncts. The left and the right. Left adjunct and right adjunct. And the left adjunct is well known, is by Frobenius, is a co-invariant vector. But there is another one, the right adjunct. When C different from P, this adjunct is just the co-invariant by the unipotent radical of the opposite parabolic multiplied by the module. Left. Parabolic induction as two dimensions. And the right, it is by the module of P if C different from P. And when C is equal to P, it question, describe it. It is not known in the degree of generality, but if you restrict to admissible, it is Emerton functor. Respect admissibility. And for admissibility, for admissible representation, it is Emerton functor, ordinary functor. But there are no descriptions for smooth representation. In fact, this description for admissible representation for C different from P for the complex case was given by Castleman. And it was generalized by Bernstein for every smooth representation. And the Méton functor was, in some sense, is another description of this done by Emerton for C is equal to P. But in general, it is not null. And so important to know that this one does not respect, so it respects admissibility, okay, when C is different from P, but not when C is equal to P. Co-invariant doesn't respect admissibility when C is equal to P. I say that because there are some people here who work mod P, and I want to tell them where you have to be careful. And but this one does. So now I can give you the definition of a cuspidal. Pi is cuspidal. The definition, if pi n is equal, let us say, if pi, when you take the two adjoint functors, goes to zero for all p different from g. Cuspidal means it doesn't come when you go down, you get always zero. Definition of cuspidal. They are quite very important. Very, very important. They are not yet constructed in general, but they are very important. Yes. It doesn't have a name. It has a name when it's admissible here, but it doesn't have a name. So Bernstein called it the second adjoint. The second adjoint, but it doesn't need a name here because you can describe it like that. Second adjoint. And it's very important, this functor. And it behaves better. So when you work mod P, it behaves better than the left adjoint because it respects admissibility. For instance, when you have GL2, you take this P and pump. So this is N for GL2, and N bar will be so I give you an example of, you know that the trivial representation is not cuspidal. You know that. You know that the Tanberg is not cuspidal. Okay? And how you know that? You look at the, you know what is happening. When you look at this functor, it goes to one, but in characteristic P, when you look at this functor, it goes to zero, in characteristic P. In characteristic P, if you look at the Sternberg, it goes to zero and it goes to one. So in some sense, in characteristic P, one is right cuspidal, if you want, but not left, and the Sternberg is left cuspidal, but not right. And when you look at the induction for GL2QP of the parabolic, then it has two components, one and Sternberg, in characteristic P. Okay, so now this talk will be about cuspidal. Question, very important question. try to understand cuspidal representation when characteristic is equal to p. And the problem is that when c is equal to p, you have the cuspidal, irreducible, admissible representation. So question, big question. Which is a big one. What are the irreducible, admissible, cuspidal representation of interest for tangential to F or G in general? For GTQP, you know, but thanks to Bartel and Livnet, plus Braille, every irreducible is admissible, and we have the classification at cuspidal 1 since 20 years. But Braille and Pascunas, for GL2F, F describe a lot of irreducible, admissible, supercuspidal, but there are too many. And we don't really know which one are interesting for arithmetic, and they have some idea what they should be, but not from the point of view of representation theory. It is as if 50 years ago, there was Harishchandra, we were studying p-adic representations, and he had to understand what was important and what was not important. We had the same point, that we don't understand. There is something that nobody understands. I don't understand it. I think nobody understands it. What should be the good definition? We have irreducible, we know, admissible, cuspidal, but there should be something else, and we don't know what it should be because of the example of Pascunas and Braille. But so Pascunas and Braille, Braille and Pascunas, constructed a lot of examples for GL2F. But besides of this, there are some examples of rank one where people have constructed cuspidal, and there were no other examples. And with Cossiol, Ersich, Cossiol, and Massel, we proved the following theorem that I will give you. There was no example, and oh, except, well, this doesn't work well. So we proved the theorem, following theorem. If characteristic of F is equal to zero, then we construct explicitly, so this is an existence, there exists at least one, but there exists an irreducible, admissible, cuspidal representation, or representation. For any gear. In fact, this construction is not so easy, but I will explain to you the idea of the construction, and I think that it could be interesting to understand what we can, we are able to construct using this method. And I think all the ones that you are able to construct using this Bayesian belong to the set of interesting cuspidal representation. So I will explain this to you as well as I can, but quickly. At least it is it is an archive, so you can find the. So I put so. It's an archive. Prove. Well, if G is compact modulo the center, every reducible representation is finite dimensional, then it is admissible and it is supercuspidal. There are no parabolic subgroup. So we suppose that G is not compact modulo the center. And then by some kind of reduction, you will reduce, so you suppose G modulo the center, not compact. Otherwise, everything is cuspidal. And you reduce reduction to G absolutely simple and adjunct. We do that. And, excuse me, I will put R here, I give the proof of R of characteristic P. Okay, this is the difficult thing because R, when C, the characteristic for R different from P, I will explain if I have the time how to do it. Of characteristic P. This is a difficult thing. And R finite. To change fields, we have with NR a method to go from one field to another field. But scalar extension, I mean, you can understand what is scalar extension when you start from an irreducible admissible representation that works extremely well. Which means that if you prove a theorem over a field that is algebraically closed or over any field that is finite, then you get the theorem for every field of the same characteristic. So this is what I intended to give for the main theme of my talk, what I thought, but that changed a little bit the stress. I was more stressed on this result than otherwise. And then the proof, there are three methods. You use three methods in order to get the result. One method will not work for the other cases. So first method, it will work for most of the group. So we take pi, we find a discrete series over C. Complex representation, there is one, with the following property, is that is vector invariant by a pro P or A, not zero, pro P or A, excuse me, then it is a module for the Hecke algebra. And it has an integral structure. Over Z Q 1 over 2, where Q is the order of the residual field. And you reduce integral structure, so I call it L, and you look at the reduction where the M is the maximal ideal. With the residual field FP. So this will be a module over FP, which is super singular. So what is this super singular module on the Proprio-Hecke algebra? So Proprio-Hecke algebra, they are algebra, they have a center. In the center, when you work over FP, or over Z, or there are elements that are not invertible. And super singular means that, well, you construct that in a canonical way. These elements, which are not invertible, should act by zero, all of them. And these elements, it suffices to consider finitely many. So super singular says that certain Hacke operators, central Hacke operators, act by zero. Super singular, like elliptic curve, something vanishes. And there is a, when C is equal to P, there is a theorem of Rachel, Olivier, and myself. We say that pi irreducible, admissible, is cuspidal if and only if is vector invariant by the prop P1A. So this is C is equal to P. This is never zero because the prop P1A is a prop P group, and this representation of a field of characteristic P is a super singular module. Some Hacke operator, central Hacke operator act by zero. Okay, so we have this, we super singular. And we have this without any, even when a characteristic is different from zero. Because it's a trick over the complex. So there are no problems. Over the complex, you don't see the difference between characteristic to FH0 or different from zero. And now you suppose characteristic of F is equal to zero, then you can find in G a discrete compact subgroup G mod gamma. And you look at the function, it's a locally constant on G mod gamma with value in C, with this, an action of G, like a translation, and it is a p-adic version of the George Wallach multiplicity theorem plus reason of Kasdan, which proves that this discrete series is contained in some representation like this for gamma small enough. You can choose something like that. But this representation is admissible. It has an integral structure, and the reduction of the integral structure is admissible. And you use this property to show, to obtain that C or FP bar, or even FP, will contain super singular element, super singular, which means an element which is fixed by the prop P1A, can put FP. And so there will be an action of the prop P1A Hacke algebra, and the central Hacke operators will act by zero. And then you take the sub-representation of C generated by F, which is super singular. It is not irreducible, but it is admissible. And because it's generated by one element, it will have a quotient that is irreducible. So you take an irreducible quotient. And then you use that is characteristic of f is equal to zero to know that the quotient of an admissible is admissible. It is false when kt of f is different from zero. So you use twice kt of f is equal to zero, once to get gamma, second to get admissibility. And this gives you the theorem. This is a proof. But it doesn't work for every g, for most of g. Then this proof will be working except in two cases. So this works if g is different from pu of h. This is a group of rank one, which is where h is a unitary group associated to Hermitian split form in three variables over a field of ramified quadratic extension of F, or also non-split for an ramified. Anyway, it's of rank one. This is all what matters. And then you use Pascuna's method. This case treated with Pascuna's method. Yeah, you don't care. Rank one, forget. It doesn't matter. I give you, there are two cases. I don't care. Pascuna's method. What is Pascuna's method? There is a tree because of rank one. You start with a super singular simple module for the Propy Wari Hack algebra, and you associate to it a coefficient system on the tree. And you look at each H0 homology, and all the irreducible quotient will be supersingular. But then you have to find one that is admissible, and then you have to use injective resolution, etc. But it's a Pascuna method that works, and it works in this case, and you do it. And this most group, you have to doesn't work for G and D. That's clear, because we know what are the discrete series. Look at the Sternberg representation, general Sternberg representation, and then they have in vector variant by the Iwari, but of dimension one, and then you reduce it, it's not supersingular. So it doesn't work. We know it doesn't work. Then at this time, we use automorphic representation. You take E, a totally regular field, and a unitary group over it. I will call it unitary group over it. And with a place V, place of E, tel que EV is equal to F. And you suppose a unitary group over E such that GV is equal to G, and which is compact at infinity. Again, it's the same method in some sense. In fact, it's just very similar to the first method. You take a group like this, and then there is a method that I will not explain, certainly not explain, to associate to it, looking at algebraic automorphic form, like Benedict Gross did, when you start from a group like that, you associate to it, you fix a level outside of V, and you associate to it a space representation of G, which is GEV, over space of of algebraic. I don't know, modular form over FP bar. Fix a level outside of you. And then you take an automorphic form, cuspidal form, of GE of A. To the automorphic modular form, this will give you some Hecke algebra and some maximal ideal of the Hecke algebra, and you take the you localize the space of modular form with respect to the maximal ideal coming from places that are away from P and good for pi and things like that. And you get that. But this one will not choose. You choose in a way that then you are using theorem, the theorem of a descent from GLN. Oh, excuse me. V is now GLND. Okay. So you take pi that for which you have some Galois group. Rho of Gal would take CM field. And you look at the automorphic form of GLN, GLND E tilde, shows that my pi is a descent of an automorphic cuspidal, algebraic, regular, self-dual and things like that, automorphic form here, automorphic representation here, for which corresponding by descent of Labes and Shin, because our group is not quasi-split, G is not quasi-split, so Labes is only when it's quasi-split at every places, but you need something of Shin when it's not quasi-split. And this by theorem of many people that we know correspond to representation of the Galois group of E tilde in GLN the QP bar. P-adic representation, you want that. And you want this one, you reduce it the reduction, and you want that if you at the place V, you want it, the reduction to be reducible. And we know cuspidal should correspond to reducible representation of the Galois group. So when you take pi like that, coming from here, corresponding to Galois like that, p-adic, with this property that reduction is reducible at V, we construct an example, and we show that this representation, if you take the vector invariant by the property, is supersingular. It was clearly admissible with the construction. So, and because it's admissible, it will have, I don't know, it has an irreducible sub-representation, which will be also super simple. So I think this construction, it will be interesting to see how many you can construct in this way, because you are not using discrete series. You are using representations that can be principal series. And the question that I am, since 20 years, I think, that it should be true, that all the interesting Cuspidal representation, I can be totally wrong, should appear by reduction of integral structures appearing in principal series. Principal series are real. You have integral structures that are not trivial, and when you reduce them and then you get Cuspidal representation, I think this are interesting. And I think this is the case, and I think it will be interesting to work more at this thought for you. Okay. So I have still 15 minutes. Okay. Now I take a look at C is equal to P, different from P. I will tell you why I look at C different from P. Because when I started to think of representation not over complex numbers but over other fields, I thought it's impossible to do anything when the field of characteristic P, I look at field of characteristic different from P. But then I look only over fields that are algebraically closed. And even wrote a book, even things like that. Our fields are algebraically closed. And we noticed with Eknath, after our work on representation over field, algebraically closed field of classic P, that in fact our class, what we did was working as well over field like FP. You don't need to suppose that field algebraically closed. And it's very useful, in fact, not to have to go up. And then I thought, well, and we didn't look at what was happening for characteristic different from P. And I look at it. And we can prove another theorem. This is not evident if you don't have this method that we develop, which is a Phoenix theorem that I will give to you. And I would like to explain to you that this method is very simple. And I think we'll work in many other contexts because it's a general theorem of algebra that will imply that you can extend results, you prove it on algebraic closed field, and you can go down. So the theorem is the following. Oh, but I have to explain something. So now I suppose that characteristic of R is different from P for a certain complex numbers, characteristic zero. Then the question is cuspidal. Irreducible implies admissible. So forget about admissibility. Cuspidal. It didn't work with to construct cuspidal, you are not using the definition that I gave. You give another characterization in the same way that when characteristic is equal to P, you are using always supersingular, never the definition. Here, cuspidal is equivalent as the coefficients of the representation. Are compact modulo the center. Are compact is there no center. And what is the coefficient of representation? You look at the linear form, the smooth one, and there are, it's not zero. And you take an element here, and coefficient is this function. if one coefficient is compact, support compact, center, then the representation is cuspidal. It is in this way that all the theorems on cuspidal representation are proved by this characterization. And as for characteristic P, you don't have coefficients, we cannot, very different. Supernularity instead of coefficient compact module de center. And you have compact induction. You start with, I will call it J, a compact open compact subgroup. No, open subgroup containing the center and compact modulo the center. And you take an irreducible representation of this group and you reduce it, compact induction. Same definition as parabolic induction, but just for the group G and compact support. And when you do that, you get something with compact coefficient modulo the center. And the conjecture is that every cuspidal irreducible representation is induced, is obtained like that. And this had been proved by different people. So another conjecture. Since Bushnian and Cusco, I mean, since 30, 40 years, that any cuspidal irreducible representation is forcible. It's not yet proved, but it has been proved for all classical groups by Stevens and other people, by GLN, by Bushnell and Cusco, by Yu and Kim and Finson for groups which are thinly ramified and P doesn't divide the order of the Weyl group. And been proved in many cases. And what I say, the conjecture is valid for any field R, not only the complex numbers. And this is a theorem that we can prove. Theorem. If, suppose that there exists a set of pairs like that. So I take R, R, algebraic closure with lambda R is a representation smooth. Representation of G with this property, such that irreducibility. That the induction is irreducible. Unicity. If is a morph then they are G conjugate. So there is G then G, so that G two and lambda two is a morph. What else do you want? Exhaustion. aîné, irréducible, super, enfin, cuspidal representation is isomorphic to for some. For some. So this is what people, when they prove they classify the cuspid representation, this is what they prove. This is the theorem that you see in the literature. But I add that this set is stable by automorphism of RR over R, by the Galois group. Which means that when you conjugate by the Galois group the lambda, then it stays in the state. It's isomorphic to the sum. Then we prove then there is a set of pairs I will give you it as a pair. You take the normalizer of the group here in G. You prove that they are compact modulo the center, which has to be proved, it's not evident. And you associate and you construct a representation rho of this group, which with rho tensor. As as a subquotient I tell you the construction. You replace J by a bigger one and lambda not by a You take the extension, and is this is irreducible, this will be also irreducible. And you find a rho here, so that this will be a subquotient, so it gives you a rho. Then there is a set of pairs. So the set of pairs. And this is a representation over R. Okay, and it is irreducible. Satisfy irreducibility plus unicity plus adjacency. And we prove that in all the cases in the literature where such thing has been done, then it satisfies also stability by this. So this means that is a theorem that in the literature, if you see a theorem prove over an algebraic closed field, quartic zero, quartic L, telling you that classifying the cuspid representation like that, then you can forget algebraically closed, you erase it, and you know it's true also with the algebraic closed. Voilà. And so the idea here comes from a result in general algebra, which is valid for every module over any ring, any algebra, which is should be in the literature, and we didn't find it in the literature, even in Bourbaki, who has chapter 8 of algebra. It is not there. Which is the following result, I think, should be part of something that we should all know, but I didn't know. If I had known when I wrote my book 20 years ago, then I would have written it when R is not algebraic closed, but I didn't know it. And the theorem is the following. If you take R, which is an R algebra field, and if you take M, which is an A module, that is simple, with endomorphism of finite dimensional. Then, for any extension, R prime, okay, which is normal. And I will tell you another condition, but it can be finite. Well, let us say, and let's say R prime contain subfield, yeah, I call it E prime, E contain, which is, well, I will tell you, a maximal subfield, separable on the center. For instance, the algebraic closure will be fine. Then, is equal direct sum delta pi. This is the division algebra. Oh, I put pi. This is division algebra over its center of dimension delta pi to the square. On the center, so if the center that we call E pi is over R, and here the maximal separable extension, the degree d pi, and here d pi. Here you have exactly, you have d pi factor, and here you have representation that is indecomposable. Length d pi same irreducible subquotient. So I did one, and to get all of them, you apply sigma at all the fixed, so like, so this means that if you go far enough, but not very far, just the algebraic closure of this, then it is of length delta pi, which is the dimension over R of the maximal commutative subalgebra that intertwines the module. So you go to this length, and then it remains the same length very quickly. And this is, in literature, you find this only over fields that are perfect fields, classic zero or finite field usually. When perfect field, all the extensions are separable. But here, you don't want only separable. The perfect field, R shouldn't be perfect. If R is not perfect, you can have the extension can be inseparable. And this is what is happening. Here it's totally indecomposable, this is totally like that. And this means that if you take the field R prime algebraic closure, then you have, if you take an irreducible representation of algebraic closure, the closure, algebraic closure of R, you associate to it, so I give you, so I give a corollary. which is what we are using, corollare. You take R prime is equal to R. There is a bijection between the pi, simple, and P. But orbits. Of absolutely simple descending to a finite action sheet. Which means that this means that pi r is equal to l r l of pi prime, where pi prime. So if you start with a simple, absolutely simple module here, we descend to a finite extension, then you can associate something like that for every R. This is how you do that. You don't have to work with absolutely reducible things when you work over R. So, and then you apply this very general result to this situation. Admissibility implies immediately that the condition is satisfied. So this is the application of for Cuspid representation is in progress. I am trying all the things that I prove with algebraically closed field to erase algebraic closed. And nothing is possible. Using some field.